today for you guys with a collective haul video. It's just a few items I've picked up here, there and everywhere over the last, actually, 4 months. So let me start off with showing you some body lotions or moisturizers I have picked up at TK Maxx. And one is the Shea Butter Body Lotion. It's a body lotion for deep moisturizing with pure shea butter. So I thought, it's nice, it's 500 milliliter, it was £5 and it has a pump. But excuse me if I sound a little bit nasal, I've been sick for the past week and my cold doesn't seem to want to go away. So my skin is suffering also. I thought I'd switch it out for a change because it's always nice to switch out skincare and body lotions, body creams, especially with the season changes. And the other one I picked up is the Amir Essential Extract Moisturizer. It's enriched with finest natural oils for exceptional skin. And this was £6 and it is 18 fluid ounce or 530 milliliter. So let's try out my two new moisturizers or body lotions. And also for my hair. At the moment I'm using a macadamia shampoo and conditioner, but my hair hasn't been too great lately and I know my hair likes argan oil. So I picked up a new shampoo, Argan Oil Ultimate Repair Shampoo. And it apparently has no sodium, chlorate, phosphate, it's paraben free. So it is, I think, a good shampoo and my hair also needs a lot of conditioner at the moment. And also for hair, I picked up the Macadamia Nut Natural Oil Deep Repair Mask, the hair mask. This was £17, a little bit more expensive, and I've heard about that macadamia natural oil brand a lot, so I thought I'll try out the mask. Maybe I will get the shampoo and the conditioner later on. And then I picked up a facial oil from Estee Lauder. I've never tried that one, but generally I really like the Estee Lauder skincare line, and this was reduced to £28, so I thought, well, let's try it. It comes in a plastic container and it's a Radiant Vitality Essence Oil. What does it say? Apply a few drops onto fingertips and smooth over your skin before you moisturize. Also, I guess it's like a serum. And yeah, as I said, I like Estee Lauder and I'm quite happy to try some new skincare as my skin is not nice at the moment, on my face, on my body and my hair. It's just a little bit suffering at the moment. My whole body is suffering a little bit. Some complexion products I repurchased, or some face products, is the MAC Prep and Prime SPF 50. Mine is nearly gone and I really don't want to run out of it. I don't want to live without it, so I already repurchased that. Another repurchase for me is the Biotherapy Hyaluronic Hydra Powder. Space NK had a £5 voucher or so, and then I thought, well, mine is not empty yet, but now with the £5 voucher they sent me on my email, I thought it's time to pick up a new Biotherapy Hyaluronic Hydra Powder. It is my favorite setting powder, and I've done a whole video about this powder. I'll leave it down below if you want to hear more about this fantastic, fabulous setting powder. And another repurchased item is the Charlotte Tilbury the Recharger Conceal and Treat Stick. And this time I picked up Fair Number 2. I used to use Fair Number 1. And this is Fair Number 2. I've already broken into it because I was completely out of my Fair Number 1. And these Recharger Treat Stick things from Charlotte Tilbury, they are so nice. I really love them. On the packaging it says, an ultra covering traceless finish conceal and treat stick to disguise imperfection, pores and uneven skin tone, enriched with black tea extract to smooth and moisture. Yeah, it is perfect for under the eyes, it is perfect for to conceal anything around my face. I really love this conceal and treat stick from Charlotte Tilbury. It's a great product. At the Dior counter I picked up a new base, and the sales girl there said it is a new product, it's been out about half a year, so it is kind of a newer product, and it's the Dior Pore Minimizer. Let me take it out. Here it is, it's the Dior Pore Minimizer. They've come out with two new primers. One is a kind of an illuminating primer, and that's the pore minimizer primer, and it's more for a matte effect. And since I'm running out soon of my Clinique one I'm using currently. I thought I'll give the Dior one a go. It comes with a pump. It's 30 milliliters in there, 1 fluid ounce. I haven't tried it yet, but yeah, once I've used up my Clinique pore minimizing product, I will break into the Dior one and see how I like it. Another product I've been dying to try for ages and I finally picked it up is the Dior Show Maximizer Lash Primer, the serum primer, lash plumping serum primer. And currently I'm using Rapid Lash and my lashes are really nice, so I thought let's give them an extra oomph and see if this will make a difference on my lashes. I've not tried it yet. It's just a white primer and yeah, I will try that out, putting it on before my mascara and see if it does make a difference. Can't wait to try out this product, I'm really excited about that. Sorry, I'm rushing through it a little bit, but I'm just not feeling well, I'm sorry. Talking of lashes, As I said, I'm using Rapid Lash at the moment, I'm quite happy with it. My lashes are really nice and strong again, and they are also a little bit longer, but I thought let's try Lilash also. That's a more expensive product, for a lash serum or lash growth product. And yeah, I'm curious to see how that Lilash compares to my Rapid Lash. I got this one from the website directly and I got the smaller size. They have a bigger size, but I think I got the one which is 3 milliliter purified eyelash serum. Yeah, once I finished up my Rapid Lash, this is the next one I'm going to be trying. Curious to see if this one is better or if this one does something different to my lashes than the Rapid Lash. And another lash product, well, it's a duo of the Benefit Day Real Mascara and the Benefit Day Real Push-Up Liner. And there was a duo, the duo was about £1 more expensive than the single Day Real Mascara, the full size. So I thought, well, let's try that liner. I'm quite curious about it. I've seen a few reviews, but normally when a new product comes out and there's a little bit of hype and people do reviews and people use it a lot and then it kind of dies down, that normally means that the product isn't as good, that people just talk about it because it's new. And I haven't heard anyone recently talking about this liner, but still I want to try it out myself and see how I like it. Okay, oh, I didn't know that. It's just a smaller one, a sample one. I don't think it's the full size. No, it isn't. But anyway, it's enough product in there to try it out. Not sure if I like it anyway, so I'm okay with it. I just thought there's a full size in there. Oh well. And I got the Benefit Day Real full size mascara. I'm using a sample at the moment and I quite like it. It's a really nice mascara. Oh, and I just found another thing in that box. There's also a sample size of their Real Remover. There's a little sample of makeup remover to remove the Real products. So I suppose this remover is supposed to be used with these two products to get the mascara off a little bit better than with normal makeup remover. Well, I don't know. Let's try it and see. And also from Benefit, I have picked up the Gimme Brow and I picked up the shade Light Medium. So many people keep talking about this product, so I thought, well, I wanna try it too. It is the one with the tiny little brush. And I think the Light Medium looks quite alright for my eyebrows. Then one product I got to try out and I got a sample is the Bare Minerals Original SPF 15 foundation. I got a tiny little sample with a tiny little brush and she gave me the shade Fairly Light, and I'm quite happy to try out that Bare Mineral powder because I've never tried it. And yeah, I'm not a powder foundation girl. For me, powder foundations, they don't last as long as liquid foundations, but it did a good job of evening out my skin tone and disguising the pores a little bit. Still, powder foundations are kind of a lot of work for me, just because probably I'm used to using liquid foundations, but yeah, I mean, it's not a bad one. I'm not sure if I would purchase the full size of it, but I'm quite happy to, having been able to try out the Bare Minerals foundation, which I've never tried before. And then at Selfridges I picked up two new products. Well, one is not new anymore, but I know Selfridges has restocked on this eyeshadow quad. It's the Tom Ford Nude Dip eyeshadow palette from the fall limited edition. And these are the special eyeshadows from Tom Ford that can be used wet or dry. Honestly, I wasn't one of these people who rushed out or tried to get that. And at Selfridges, I had no problem getting this product. They even restocked it this week on Tuesday. Here in the UK, I don't think it was hard to get hold of. But anyway, that's the Tom Ford Eye Color Quad in Nude Dip. Obviously, I've used it already a little bit. Of course, I had to play around with it a little bit. And that's what the eyeshadows look like. They are very pretty neutral eyeshadows. And the texture is very smooth and shimmery. They swatch nice, they go on nice. Just really nice eyeshadows. Here they are swatched. If you don't like shimmer, this eyeshadow quad probably isn't for you, because all of these eyeshadows are very shimmery. A neutral palette like this is, for me, definitely one I will get lots of use out of. That's why I picked it up. But as I said, I didn't rush to get it. I just walked into Selfridges one day and then I saw it, I swatched it, and I thought, I had no intention of getting it, but after I saw it and I swatched it, I thought, it's a good one. I'm actually wearing this one on my eyes again today. All I need in addition with it is a matte brow bone color. I can't only use these four eyeshadows for a whole eye look. And also, these can be used wet, but I hardly ever use any of my eyeshadows wet, if I'm honest. So I didn't buy this quad because I want to use them wet. I just bought it because they're beautiful eyeshadows. And shades I know I will wear a lot, which at Tom Ford's price point, that is really important. And then at Charlotte Tilbury, I picked up one of her new formula lipsticks, and it's the Matte Revolution Luminous Modern Matte Long Lasting Lipstick. That's the new lipsticks she came out with, the matte ones, and she's got loads of colors in that line, and beautiful colors, from nudes to pinks to peaches to reds to plummy colors. Really, really nice. I wore that lipstick already once just to see how it wears on my lips. I picked up a lovely fall color, and it's kind of a red, nice berry red. I posted an Instagram picture wearing this lipstick, and it looks beautiful with that Tom Ford eyeshadow palette. I really like wearing this eyeshadow palette and this lipstick together, especially for this time of the year, but beautiful. And from that day when I wore it, I can say I'm impressed. They are not drying. They're still kind of a little bit more of a creamier matte, even though they're nothing like cream sheens or cream lipsticks. As you can see, the lipstick really has a proper matte finish, but they feel comfortable on the lips without sliding around, and they're creamy enough. So if you are someone who doesn't like to wear matte lipsticks because it dries out your lips, maybe, you know, try the Charlotte Tilbury matte ones. She's done a really good job with the formula on these matte lipsticks. Granted, I only tried out one shade so far, but in future I probably will get more of these matte lipsticks. I'm a matte lipstick lover. I love my matte lipsticks. I think matte lipsticks are just easier to wear on an everyday basis, even in a color like that bright berry color. Oh, did I say what it is? It's Love Liberty. That's Charlotte Tilbury. Love Liberty. Lastly, some drugstore items I've picked up at the drugstore. I've probably picked up a few more items, but I've already put them away over the past few months. I picked up a couple of the Real Techniques Miracle Complexant Sponge. Then from Real Techniques, I picked up the Lash and Brow Groomer. These kind of products are always handy to have, and they had a 3-4-2, so I picked up two of these sponges and this lash groomer from Real Techniques. And then another repurchase, because I love it, is the Rimmel Scandalize Eye Pencil in Nude. It is the perfect shade for my eyes. It just brightens up my eyes if I put that in the waterline, and I really don't want to run out of that. I wear it nearly every day, so needed to repurchase that one. And then I picked up a lip balm, and this is Lano Lips. I heard Sharon, makeup artist, talking about Lanolips a lot. So when I saw that in Boots, it was £10, which is not cheap for a drugstore lip balm, but apparently it's good. So let's try it. Right, that's it. That's pretty much most of the products I've picked up over the past few months, and I'm gonna quickly say goodbye. I think I'm gonna just go and wash off my makeup and have a lie down again, because my body really, really needs it. So with that, I say goodbye for now. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Lots of love. Until next time, from Cornelia.